What was it like to have Floyd in the corner talking to you?
It was good. I mean, he's a good dude. He takes interest in his fighters. Like Paulie said in the telecast, like so many people look up to him. If you can have him giving you advice and mentoring your career, that's an added bonus. Like how can you go wrong with that? You can't. He's just a very sincere and very honest person, man. He does a lot for a lot of people.
That's a misconception about Floyd. Like when you see Floyd, what the media likes to show is they like to show the controversial part. They like to no one wants to see the good part, the good stuff that Floyd does.
He does a lot
so,
of good.
So they show the negative. They want to put up stuff about police reports. They want to talk about the 50 Cent beef. They want to talk about all that, but they don't show what he does for fighters or what he does for his friends or you know what I'm saying. Like the first time I met Floyd, I was so nervous because everybody had built up this big monster. You know what I'm saying? They built up this big monster of who he was and stuff like that. And I met Floyd and he started talking to me. You know what I'm saying? Just simple, just regular conversation.
Being cool.
He's a good guy. Yeah, good guy, man. Every time we see each other, you know what I'm saying? It's always like, hey, what's up, Floyd? You know, hey, what's up, Zach? You know, he'll go out of his way to say hi to me. I'll go out of my way to say hi to him. You know, he's good people. So.
Two years ago, I'm at the Mayweather gym and Floyd pulls me over and he says, I want you to go talk to Ishe. Floyd knew you'd be champion. How did he know?
He just knew the hard work. And you know all the struggles and all the dedication. He told me I'm gonna get you a title shot. I hadn't fought for 18 months. In less than a year, I fought twice, and then the third fight I'm fighting for a world title, and all within less than a year.
And now you're famous. Do you like that, being on the spot, everybody talking about you and throwing names at you and calling you out? And
man, I'm just trying to stay humble. To me, I'm still that broke kid, man. I'm still the kid 3 years ago that lost, didn't have nothing, that was catching the bus to the gym.
You're kidding.
Keeping it all humble.
Yeah. And they send you that belt. We told you.
I'm still waiting, man.
When they send you the belt, when you get your copy of the belt, that's when you stick.
Wow, took a bus to the gym, and now he's a world champion. Hard work pays off, huh?
Hard work, dedication.
So these are the people that we be around, and that's why we got Zach and I got stepping up to that next level to be where they're at right now.
So. Them tears that Ishe had at the end of his fight were like, they were like perfect for the simple fact that no one knows the struggles that you go through as a boxer. No one knows what you put in. You know, broken face, broken hands, broken noses, you know.
The money is not always there.
Yeah, the money's not always there. Sick, you know what I'm saying? Going to the gym when you don't want to. Yeah, hurt legs, you know what I'm saying? Barely walking, stuff like that. You know, when you get your nose broken, you can barely breathe out of your nose and stuff. Busted lips, stitches. You know, it's hard work. This is unlike any other sport. This ain't football. It's not basketball. It's not soccer. It's none of those. It's none of those contact sports that they say are tough or anything like that. Because at the end of the day, only person that you can blame is yourself. There's only two people that's gonna. There's only three people in the ring. Only one person can save you, and that's the ref. The rest you got. If you don't take the sport seriously, this like Roger Mayweather says it best. You gotta protect the sport and love the sport and nurture the sport, because there's people that come into the sport and walk away not knowing their names. You know what I'm saying? Not being able to move right. You know what I'm saying? And that's how serious you have to take the sport. Every one punch can end everything in this sport.
This is how bad Ishe wanted to fight. He fought with a hurt rib. And Zach did too. Actually, his last fight also.
So. But my hurt rib wasn't, you know, as dramatic as Ishe. You know, if I would have fought for a belt, I would have threw my hurt rib out there.
So, you know, he did what he had to do to get that W, so, you know, we're all proud of him.
There you have it. Ishe Smith, the world champion, EsNewsBoxing.com, voice effect recording.